And you're right, this is a very complex situation. A long time ago, I had a phrase I said that part of the problem with local government, and really all government, is that it operates in a culture of complexity, where we take already difficult situations and we make them more difficult. And this is Exhibit A of that. For those just tuning in, we have been discussing an 11th hour discovery of a $712,000 shortfall after we have spent days honing in on a budget to the penny. This is serious. This wasn't a minor accounting error. This is a major accounting error. And the outrage that Commissioner Henson Rawls shared over the hiring, the quarterly hiring report, and the need to hold charter officers accountable is what I feel on this. I am frankly, I did a bit review and heard glowing recommendations of outstanding for our officers. Outstanding. Taking fantastic measures to mitigate the impact of these costs. Criticism was not tolerated. In fact, it was besmirched. You criticized, you were dismissed. Now, I appreciate Ms. Hunt, our CFO, accepting responsibility. She's the chief financial officer. But to be blunt, commissioners, she has been asked to perform financial gymnastics that no CFO in the state of Florida has had to do in the last 20 years because of this issue. And every time commissioners, whether it's Commissioner Chase or new mayor-elect Braddy or citizens from the public, have tried to, at earlier times, drill down on these finances, they have been dismissed, and you know it. You all know it. We've dismissed that opportunity to hone in on these numbers much earlier. Now, just a few more things I want to say, because it's correct. Commissioner Wells is correct. We have talked about reducing the base rates for quite some time. Commissioner Chase is correct that that is against the cost of study report that we've paid good money for. Okay? I was criticized for using the word gimmick. Folks, look it up. That's the definition. We've done that. We've done that for this reason. And it's stunning. It is stunning. We're taking a complex web, and we have, by our unwillingness to drill down earlier, we have made it much more difficult, and that's why we've had this accounting error. Commissioner Hawkins is correct. It really isn't the CFO's job of the utility to tell general government what the utility tax is going to be. So general government missed that one. I would say that that's a stunner for me, except for the fact that at a meeting earlier, when we're talking about an FTE for a very controversial mayor's aide, the response I got is, oh, we just missed that too. A few more thoughts, and then we do need to move on, and I agree with Commissioner Poe, we just need to figure out how to close the gap. But I guess the point I'm trying to drive home is let's not be so quick to dismiss those of us who insist that, A, charter officers provide directions to their financial officers. They are accountable. And we are in this web because of those decisions and our indifference to it earlier. And I would add that I wrote some terms down while we were getting the sort of the mea culpa. We missed this piece. Focus off the ball. And then here's the big one. we weren't following, and this is paraphrased, but I wrote the word down, traditional process. We all know we are not following traditional processes of running a healthy utility. We are not. We have deviated on the UPIF, and I commend Commissioner Hawkins for catching it, and for the rest of us for agreeing we shouldn't be doing that. We are deviating from the way a fuel adjustment is supposed to be done. And we are, and we could go down the list, and we don't need to. We are deviating from this dramatic drop in base rates and a spike in the fuel adjustment. These are deviations. And so the best way forward, we'll figure out a way to get through this, I have no doubt, because we do have talented people, we have talented staff. We'll figure this budget out. But I hope we all make this commitment that one way or the other, even if it means some more short-term pain, we get out of this unconventional approach to financing a utility. And we hold those who have gotten us to this point directly accountable for it. Because this is, to me, unacceptable. We have spent so many hours trying to drill it, get it down, and then we get nearly $750,000 thrown at us and say, oh, we're off. Let's figure this out. So we've got to hold it. You know, I will say this. I am committing myself. We're always, and another thing that has sort of irked me is being told every time we've tried to ask these questions, I've heard from some other commissioners, well, hey, these numbers are so big, that's why we have our professional staff. They're the experts. Which kind of implies we just have to defer to them. Well, folks, we've done it too long. And I'm not saying we have to be experts in the utility, but the American Public Power Association offers webinars for elected officials like us to help us, and I'm committing myself to participating in these. They cover subjects like assessing the future of the public power's business model, how public power is governed, duties, responsibilities of governing boards, okay, strategic issues, other things on the finance rate making for utility boards and city councils. You know, frankly, as part of our orientation, I would think GRU would have informed us of these opportunities, and I wouldn't have had to discover it on my own or with the help of others, okay? But nonetheless, I'm bringing that to our attention, and I hope we try to make work into our already busy schedules the opportunity to participate in these because, frankly, we need to be more committed to drilling down on these financial numbers ourselves and to recognize a red flag when it first starts to get waved, when we start deviating from a normative financial model, we should all hit our buttons and say, what's going on here? Why? Instead of saying, well, you know, they're the experts. I guess we'll just have to defer to the experts. We're done deferring, folks. All right. That's my rant for the 10th hour. We'll see you at 11 o'clock.